Legacy West. I don't know if I vlogged it, but I went to the Mac, and I got some things. I got some things and I was given some things. So I'm going to be filming a full face video using Mac products. Woo. Hopefully I can pull something together. I still have my old palette. I know it looks untouched, but that's because some of the shades are not even used. But I'm gonna film a full face, and I'm gonna tell y'all about the deals that they have going on in September specifically. You can actually call this MAC and they will ship products out to you for free. Okay? Like they pull them from the shelves and ship it for you. That's what I'm getting ready for this morning. And then I have to obviously clean this up and clean some brushes and order some brushes because I realize I don't have that many MAC brushes and I actually quite like them. Welcome back to my bathroom. I feel like we're always in my bathroom. I purchased this. This is from the Allure Pro collection. They create these cleansers. These are brush cleansers. This one is in the scent Daydream. And hold on. It smells really clean. It reminds me of my mother likes to use these air fresheners and stuff that are like, you know, the fresh scent and cotton field or so. I don't know, that sounds very inappropriate, but the point is that it smells clean and it also conditions your brushes. What I've seen from this, the reason why I purchased it is because this stuff works so good. It's formulated so well. People use it on things that are not their brushes, like their clothes and their carpet and their rugs, which is kind of funny because I mean, when do women ever buy something and it doesn't work for something else, you know? And it doesn't sound impressive when I talk about it. I mean, even if you saw the videos, you'd be like, okay, it just looks like you're cleaning your brushes. But this soap specifically can pull product out of foundation brushes, which is what impressed me. And they do sell like a little mat to clean your brushes with, by the way. Just an FYI, if you're one of those people who has to have a mat, it's definitely more efficient to clean your brushes that way. Well, well. I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised. Aloe is not a gimmicky person. she's pretty straightforward. And she doesn't mess around. So, yay!
I filmed the tutorial. Okay, so crazy thing. I actually fell asleep after I filmed my eyes. So I woke up this morning and I finished the tutorial. And now I'm on my way to MAC, the Legacy West location where they're having the sale. And I'm gonna go take some photos inside of the store. You know, and just show you guys around in the store so you can see what it looks like because it's actually a boutique. It's not a humongous MAC store or a counter. It's a little boutique and it's the cutest thing and I can't wait to show you guys. Okay, y'all, so I am here. I got my mask on. I don't know if y'all can hear me with all the cars and stuff. Y'all, it is hot. This is what I'm wearing. My slippers are fancy, okay? They're fancy. I feel like they're good enough for Legacy West. I mean, not that I care anyway, but I just didn't want to be uncomfortable on my way here and on my way back. Okay, so if you didn't know, you actually cannot apply your foundations now. Like, you can't use testers anymore, which is just for everyone's safety.
But they have this really cool QR code that you can use to actually try it on. And if you see my latest video, then you know that this thing works and it's so cool. It's so cool. Okay. They actually have it for the foundations. They also have it for the lip products. And look at this. Yeah, keep it to yourself. I love how they have the bubbles on the lipstick caps. It's giving me OCD dreams come true. But yeah, so. Oh my god, this is so cute. This is a locker that they have. And right now, they're doing a giveaway. And these are the kits that I was talking about. So basically, you spend $70 instead of $100 and you get a trio. Same thing over here. So these are essentials kits. And essentials are basically things that you will always purchase or pick up, which is your foundation, your primer, and your setting spray, or your foundation and your primer. I actually wound up getting my liquid foundation last time and a sunscreen. These are the other kits. So these are the ones that are more customizable. And again, you wind up spending a little bit less than you would if you purchased these items any other day. I just got a call from my property where I live, and maintenance is on the way, so I didn't get to have fun and linger like I wanted to. But as y'all saw, they're having sales, okay? They have a cool locker where you can win prizes based off of what you purchased, etc., etc. So make sure you visit Legacy West, the MAC boutique, so that you don't miss out on these deals during this pandemic. Because let me tell you something, they're not happening anywhere else, okay? Okay. I'm on my way to my studio, and I have to speed, y'all, because they're talking about they're going to come right after lunch. And I'm like, I hope that y'all are not prompt, because I'm all the way in Plano. Like, who? You know, I put in a ticket for my refrigerator because I don't think I mentioned this. So I had come home from work, and all of the ice in my refrigerator was melted. All of my frozen food had thawed completely out. Nothing was cold per se. Like, everything was wet, but it wasn't cold. At least not cold enough for me to save it. And y'all, it was like $400 worth of food in my refrigerator, because I accumulate food like a squirrel. Like, I don't just go buy everything I need all at once. I kind of go to the store, I get things here and there, because you really never know what you're gonna need when it comes to groceries, at least for me. So yeah, all my food just gone. All of my meat, all of my gelato, y'all, all of my Talenti gelato gone, y'all. And you know, like my frozen fries, because you know I can't eat regular potatoes all the time, I have to eat sweet potatoes. But all my food was gone. So I had contacted maintenance, and I'd asked them, you know, if there was a power outage or whatever, because it had been storming for 2 days, you know. It had been storming for 2 days, so I was like, maybe the power went out, maybe my neighbor didn't pay their bill, and my electricity is connected to theirs, like, I don't know. And basically what I was told was to make sure that it wasn't my electricity provider. So I looked, we didn't have a power outage, which, you know, I was like, it couldn't have been, because when I got up, I got up really early in the morning, my refrigerator was fine. The refrigerator was fine. All the lights were working. Yada, yada, whoop-de-whoop. So they're just coming to, and the refrigerator started working again. It started working again like machines do, making me look like boo-boo the fool. I'm afraid to buy food, because I'm like, I can't lose hundreds of dollars worth of food. Like, that's not something that I could just come out of pocket about. Like, I just can't do that. Alexa, volume to 3. But I made it back to my studio, and maintenance has not made it here yet. So I'm gonna clean up. I have to clean my kit because I have a bride in, I think, 16 days. I have to clean my kit and just make sure everything is in order. And then this lovely mess that I made filming this tutorial for Mac. So, and then I'm gonna clean my face and exercise. Change my engine and cabin air filters, and then I also had to replace a whole tire. So I wound up spending almost $300 today. It's more fun when I'm spending it on stuff I want to spend it on, like food, but it's okay, you know, that ain't nothing that we can't earn back. We just gotta keep it rolling, hustle and bustle, you know. This is what adults do. Adults spend money on stuff that they don't want to spend money on. Yeah. Finished the video. I didn't know if I mentioned this in my other, when I was last vlogging, but I wanted to film this look for the Hot Chef. And basically, it's just Hot Cheeto inspired goodness.
I'm watching Aaliyah's vlog and making some stir fry ramen. But yeah, so I don't have, I'm not gonna say I don't have food, but I don't have the ability to be whipping myself up stuff, not physically, and I don't have the materials, so there's that. And tomorrow the maintenance guy is supposed to come and let me know if they have what I need for this refrigerator, and then I sent in an email to the property management office because I was like, I don't know, y'all let me know if this has ever happened to you. Has your refrigerator ever gone out and spoiled literally all of your food? What did you do? How did you get compensated? One of my coworkers was telling me that I should file a claim with my insurance, like my renter's insurance, so we'll see. But yeah, that's what I'm about to do. I'm gonna drink some water. I might drink some of this white peach sake. Look, y'all, I got the big bottle. This stuff is so, so good, especially with some fresh fruit. I love it. But yeah, that's what I'm about to do, so. Gave my sister her kids back and I am cleaning because I finally got the mat for the rug that I bought from Ruggable, and I also have groceries to put away, and I also have a vanity to clean. I got so much stuff. So first of all, this PR is from Tula, by the way. I have a code with them. My favorite product from them right now is the sunscreen. I am so glad they sent me this because I actually lost the first bottle that I got. So I have the sunscreen, and I also have a code with them. The code is Christina. You know my username. So that's what I'm about to do. Y'all. Oh, and I did get some stuff in the mail. Okay, so the first thing that I got was from Amazon. I'm gonna open this up. I'm pretty sure I know what this is. Pretty sure. I don't know what these shoes are emulating, who the shoes are emulating, because I know that a lot of brands and companies make fake shoes, but or fake versions of popularized name brand shoes. But I needed some shoes for work, so I got these in a size 9. I feel like when it comes to running shoes or athletic shoes, it's better to get half size up, so I got a 9 because I don't want my toes to be uncomfortable. And this is what they look like. They are a European size 40. Let's see, it says, yeah, it's a European size 40. They're lined with They're lined with cotton. It says upper textile, outsole MD. Not sure what that means, but I'm pretty sure it's just like a type of rubber. So I'm going to pop these on when I get ready to go, because today I'm going to DoorDash. One of my Instagram homies asked me if I've been DoorDashing lately, and I was like, you know what? No. But before I do that, I'm going to clean up all of this. You guys, just as I was getting like putting all this together, the FedEx man came to my door, y'all. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, y'all, so I finished my living room. And now I'm getting ready to make myself a nice little protein shake, smoothie, whatever you want to call it. What I'm going to do first is take my protein powder. Ooh. This is the protein powder that I use. This is by Carrington Farms. I think I showed it earlier in the vlog. But I'm just going to get one scoop. It's basically a vegan protein powder. So I'm going to put that in there and put this back. I decided not to use a more traditional protein powder because I'm afraid that it's going to affect my body negatively. And that is the last thing that I need going on right now in my life. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of my almond milk and I'm going to pour it right on top of the powder. Okay. And the almond milk that I use right now, or that I've been enjoying, is Califia Farms. And it's basically soy-free, dairy-free, gluten-free, carrageenan-free, and then it has 40% more calcium than milk, according to the packaging. So I just poured, it looks like I think I did about 8 ounces. And I'm also going to add this peanut butter. I recently went on Twitter and was asking everybody, how the heck do I get my protein powder texture to not be gross? And everybody basically said milk, peanut butter, and shaking it up before you blend it. So I'm doing that. And I'm gonna open this real quick and pop these bananas in there. So this is basically a peanut butter and banana smoothie. I don't need too much potassium, so I'm not gonna add a ton of this. Ooh, but these bananas are a little overdue. Something else you want to keep in mind, you guys, is the more ice you add to your protein smoothie or your shake, whatever you want to call it, the thicker it's going to be. So, especially when you consider the ratio of the ice to whatever liquid you're using. I like to rinse the lid off once I've opened it because I don't like a mess being on the outside. This is one of my reusable straws. It's not super long, but whatever. So I just finished filming. This is the look. I went on Instagram Live and I did my base, but the eyes are the tutorial. So right now I'm just gonna make myself something to eat and I think I'm gonna write a little bit. I was thinking about editing, but part of me feels like, no, don't do it. I don't know. What I do know is this glitter. It's cute. Like, look at my eyes, y'all. Look at my eyes. I'm gonna have so much fun taking this off. In like an hour. In the browser, Kat Von D. Good morning. Good morning, you guys. Oh my goodness. It is Saturday, and I am exhausted. I don't know if you can see it on my face, but I am super drained. And I am trying so hard not to be, but it's not working. It's not working. I made myself get some rest. I think I went to bed at like 2. And I woke up at like
10 or 9:30. I don't know. I'm just so tired and I have a headache. I just went for a walk and I'm gonna eat some fruit for breakfast, but what I'm gonna do is edit a video that I filmed yesterday, that makeup look with all the blue, and then I'm also going to edit this vlog so that it can be uploaded on Sunday. But yeah, there's not much. I mean, I don't have anything to do today. I keep trying to get rest and it doesn't work. Like, either I don't sleep, I don't rest at all, or I do rest and nothing happens. Like, it doesn't help. So, anywho,
this is what I wore outside. These joggers are from Walmart. They were like $10. And then I got these cute little shoes from Amazon. They're actually very comfortable. I mean, I didn't stand and walk in them for too long, but they're pretty comfortable. And then this top, I don't know where it's from. Someone's mother gifted it to me, but yeah. So I'm just gonna sit down and edit.
Oh, I hope y'all can hear me. I don't know where I left off on the vlog, but let me tell y'all. So I woke up this morning and I think it was like 11 a.m. when I last checked in on the vlog. So, hold on. To edit, and y'all, I literally was feeling like I don't even know, like it was a mess. It's a lot of noise, but I was feeling nauseous, I was feeling dizzy. I don't know what it was, but I laid down, like I sat down and I kept laying my head down on my couch, and then I just finally laid in my bed, and let me tell y'all, I did not get up until almost 5 p.m. So I don't know if I'm just exhausted or worn out or what. Yesterday I did have one of my nieces and one of my nephews with me, and I kept wanting to fall asleep, but of course I didn't let myself because I'm taking care of them, you know. So I'm up now. It's 7 o'clock. Sorry, y'all have to get away from that noise because the freaking truck that's driving by. But anyway, so I think I got up at like 5 something and I ate food. I tried to eat breakfast this morning. I tried to eat berries, but I just was not feeling it. So now I'm on my way. People keep asking me if I replaced Snowflake with Nelly. I did not. Nelly did not replace Snowflake. She's a trained dog, so like she doesn't. I can take care of her. I can babysit her or watch her for someone. And she doesn't make noise. She doesn't bark. She doesn't
get scared, like, you know, because she's a trained service dog. So, oh my God, Tulip, are you serious? So, that's why I have her all the time. Not everybody can watch their dogs or leave their dogs at home because, you know, they don't like to be by themselves. I know sometimes I have to have people watch Tulip because, you know, but she's pretty good on her own for the most part. Anywho, I'm going to end the vlog here. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. I hope that it wasn't boring. We'll see what next week is going to be like. And yeah, please don't forget to subscribe. Like this video. Share it with one of your homies. Please, please. And if you think you're subscribed, please double check. Because I'm trying. I have a goal. You know, I have a goal. And you are part of that goal. So join the fam. And I will see y'all in the next one. Yeah.